Bayfield and Jenkins met at an afternoon meeting of the Euterpe Club, of which she was, of course, director of music. That evening, they ran into each other again at a party on Riverside Drive, and their courtship began. He was very attracted to her dynamic personality, and she to him for his aristocratic bearing and savoir-faire. To the end of her life, he would remain loyal to her, observing the anniversary of their meeting that day with a remembrance of flowers. She now always had a handsome escort, and Bayfield eventually became the unofficial manager of her professional affairs. On the following August 16th of 1909, Florence and he were actually married in a symbolic but non-legal ceremony at the Hotel Vanderbilt with four witnesses present. He gave her his grandmother's wedding ring, and she gave him what she called a ring of entwining love, a gold ring with a blue lapis lazuli stone, which he always wore on the fourth finger of his left hand. At Florence's insistence, theirs was a common law marriage. It is entirely possible that she and Dr. Jenkins had never been divorced, and that she was not free to marry another. She was still married to Dr. Jenkins in 1906, and he was simply never mentioned again. Florence probably never divorced him, so she would not have to suffer the shame of a divorced woman. By 1916, Dr. Jenkins had died. As their clandestine relationship deepened, Florence ensconced St. Clair in a poorly ventilated, cramped, fourth-floor walk-up apartment above a real estate office at 66 West 37th Street in 1919. She paid the rent and considered this a sort of salary towards the work that he did for her and the clubs. She herself lived in various semi-posh hotels around the city, eventually settling for good in the Hotel Seymour. She would occasionally go to St. Clair's apartment to flee from the telephone. He was expected to host a Christmas wine party for her friends there and decorate his apartment, something he rather enjoyed, including a tree with real candles. In spite of the fact that she always lived separately in luxury and he in less than comfortable rooms, he loved her and they never quarreled. Bayfield nicknamed her Bunny, and her pet name for him was Whitey. Arranging Florence's other affairs, he booked the venues for the club meetings, banked the money, and was de facto head of Florence's public relations. But by 1932, their relationship had become only professional. It came to the point that one could not survive without the other. Bayfield couldn't last without Florence's financial support, and she needed him as producer, writer, director, and actor in her many club events.